In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to make your photos better fast.
Okay, everybody, positions. Roll sound. Roll camera. Action.
Hey guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we're gonna talk about...
Ciao guys, my name is Gašper Jagar and today I'm gonna show you a few easy steps how you can make your photos much better in Adobe Lightroom Mobile. For those of you who may not know, Adobe Lightroom is one of the top softwares used for photo editing, and there's a mobile version which in my opinion is one of the best softwares you can have on iOS or Android for photo editing. So today I'm gonna take you through a few easy steps on how to make this into this. Now the first part we are gonna check is the light segment. You have 6 sliders here. And I'm just gonna walk you very briefly through what they do. Now, exposure sets brightness through the entire image. You know, it affects everything. Contrast also makes the image more contrasty or less contrasty, and it affects the entire image. And then you have 4 settings. So highlights, shadows, whites, and blacks. Now, what do these do is that they affect a part of the image. Highlights and shadows affect mostly like mid-dark or mid-bright parts, while whites and blacks are the whitest and the darkest parts of the image. Now, just a very quick thing, you know, on top here we have what is called a histogram. A histogram shows us which areas of the image are the brightest or the darkest. Now, the part on the left is the dark tones, the dark areas, and the part on the right is the bright areas. This can serve you as a guideline. In theory, it's the best to kind of have the brightness of the image in the middle. So, you know, just kind of try to keep that histogram in the middle, but you also need to kind of see what you're doing. This is just a tool to help you out. So the first thing I do is I raise shadows a little bit, just, you know, to get that detail from the darker parts of the image, and I drop the highlights. This is just to get the information out of the bright and the dark parts. The second thing is that I raise the whites and I lower the blacks. This is just to give image some contrast. Now, when this is done, I also play with the general contrast of the image, just kind of raise it up a little bit to what I like it. And I'm just gonna leave exposure for now because I think the image is fine. If we check the original and what we have now, it's already a huge difference, you know, and it looks a lot better. The second part we're gonna check is the color tab. So in color tab, we have 3 things we're gonna look at. The first two are vibrance and saturation. Now, what do these do is they affect the intensity of colors in your image. Saturation, for example, affects the entire image in the same way. And if I go up, you can see that all the colors are really strong. And if I go all the way down, we get a black and white image. Now, vibrance, on the other hand, also affects the intensity of colors, but it affects the ones that are set here at, in my example, at 6050 kelvins, which is the current white balance of the image. So if I raise vibrance, it mostly, for example, here affects the bluer colors instead of, for example, all of them. If I lower it a little bit, I get a black and white image, but there are certain colors which are the furthest away from the white balance, which are still here. My suggestion is that, you know, play with vibrance first and then add some saturation if you still think that image is missing something. So I'm gonna raise vibrance a little bit to get that blue out of the shadow, you know, out of the mystic tones, kind of give it that Game of Thrones feeling. And I think I'm just gonna, you know, leave saturation for now, almost, and just leave it at 0. The third part is grading, but let's first jump to the effects panel before we tackle that one. Now, at the effects part, this is where we get give the image some, you know, some punch. So the setting here that's the most important one is clarity. You know, clarity is kind of like artificial sharpness of your image. So the more clarity you have, the sharper your image is gonna look, at least from like as a thumbnail. And the further down you go, the blurrier the image is gonna be. So normally what you wanna do is raise clarity at least a little bit. So for me, for example, I'm just gonna go here. This looks cool. It's good to give images a little bit of punch because that way they kind of look better on your Instagram feed. And then there is just one more thing you can play with to kind of get more of that, let's say, creative look. Now, it used to be called split toning, but now in the new version, it's called grading. Now, what grading does is you've got three color wheels for shadows, midtones, and highlights. And what it does, it affects the colors in those areas. So for example, if I want to make my darker areas a bit more green looking, I just take it and go up. And the further away from the center of the circle you go, the more saturation there is. So as you can see right now, if I go around, the sky stays white, but all the other colors change. The midtones kind of affect, you know, just the middle part of the histogram. And the highlights affect, you know, just the sky. As you can see, the darker areas are basically the same as they were. You can play with this to get any look you want. How I normally do this, if I just do it really quickly, I just take shadows and just go more towards blue, greenish look. Like, for example, something like this. And then I take my highlights and I just go into the yellow a little bit. And then below here, you've got your balance slider. Basically what this means is it decides how much of one or another is it going to apply. Basically, it's kind of like a spillover between them. So as you can see, if I slide up and down, you can see how the shadows or the highlights are more affected one or the other. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm just gonna leave it more into the shadows because I like that Game of Thrones, Winter is Coming kind of feel about it. So let's just see. So this is the image we have now, and this is the image we had before. Wow, huge difference. And this is something you can do very basically just for, you know, just in a few steps for every one of your photos, and it really make a huge difference on what the end result is. So just let me show you with these easy steps, as you get used to it, how fast you can actually edit a photo to get a better look really fast. Ready, set, go. And we're done. So this is the finished photo and this is the original photo. Now, there's a huge part of the personal preference of what you want to do. So this is just an example of how you can do it, but what will you do? That's on you because it's your photo. So thank you guys for watching this. If you have any more questions about Lightroom, if you want to know more, let's say detailed stuff on how you can do things, also like in fast steps, let me know in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Give this video a thumbs up if you found it useful or if you liked it, or both. And I will see you in the next one. Ciao.